Hank Williams was born September 17, 1923 at New Georgiana, Alabama. By age 13, he had organized his first band. And in 1936, they went to work for a radio station in Montgomery, Alabama. They stayed with that station until 1948. During those years, Hank grew up, married, and made his first records. That first recording session was in Nashville on December 11, 1946, for Sterling Records.
Never again will I knock on your door.
But nothing much happened for Hank until 1949, when he recorded a song called The Lovesick Blues. This song had been recorded several years earlier by Rex Griffin, and in fact, Hank's version was almost exactly the same. And ironically, the record that made Hank a star, the record that brought him fame and got him a job on the Grand Ole Opry, was written by someone else. Wesley Rose, a Nashville publisher, recalls Hank's first appearance on the Grand Ole Opry.
So Roy Acuff introduced Hank, and my father and I were sitting out in the audience. And it was real scary because they said, now we want to present a newcomer called Hank Williams. Well, the silence was deafening, and it kind of scared the life out of us. Then he started singing Love Sick Blues, and we went into his first yodel. It was like a standing ovation from then on, and Hank Williams, being an entertainer that loved to be in front of people, just got better and better and better, and it was an impossibility to get him off the stage, and we were pretty proud of Hank that day.
I got a feeling of the blues, oh Lord, since my baby said goodbye. Lord, I don't know what I'll do. All I do is sit and sigh. Oh, Lord, that last long day she said goodbye. Well, Lord, I thought I would cry. She'll do me, she'll do you. She's got that kind of loving. Lord, I love to hear her when she calls me sweet. Daddy, such a beautiful dream. I hate to think it all over. I've lost my heart, it seems. I've grown so used to you somehow. Well, I'm nobody's sugar daddy now. And I'm lonesome. I got the lovesick blues.
Hank Williams was a troubled soul who drank heavily. Minnie Pearl remembers one of Hank's drinking spells.
One time I played San Diego. We were riding around, and the promoter was told me to keep him from getting any further medication that would make him unable to play the show that night. There were two other people in the car, and I was sitting on the back seat, and Hank was sitting on the front. He was turned around looking at me, and he said, all right, let's sing. So he started singing a song that he wrote. It was a hymn called I Saw the Light. He started singing, I saw the light, I saw, and then he stopped. And he turned and he looked at me with those dark, brooding eyes that I remembered from Dothan, Alabama so many years before. And he said, Minnie, that's the trouble. There ain't no light.
Now I'm so happy, no sorrow inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light.
One of America's biggest country music stars wasn't even born here. He was born in Nova Scotia, Canada in 1914. He went to sea when he was 12. He was a lumberjack in Oregon at 15 and a horse wrangler at 16. He bought a guitar for $15 and went all through Halifax picking and singing and finally got a job at a radio station in Halifax. He joined the Canadian Broadcasting Corporation in 1934, and in 1937 he's made his first record for RCA Victor Records of Canada.
I hope you have heard the story and the song.
In case you don't recognize him, that's Hank Snow. For this first effort, his royalty check was $1.96. But he got the chance to record again. His second record was a hit by the standards of those days. The Girl in the Blue Velvet Band.
If you listen, a story I'll tell you of a girl who once lived in this world.
His popularity continued to grow in Canada until finally RCA Victor agreed to release one of his Canadian records in the United States.
Now all I have left is your brand on my heart.
This record became number one in Dallas, Texas on a 50,000-watt station for 16 straight weeks. Finally, through the help of Ernest Tubb, he was able to join the Grand Ole Opry on January 7th, 1950. Listen now as Hank tells what happened next.
The first 3 months for me on the Grand Ole Opry, trying to compete with well-known and established artists, was heartbreaking. And I have heard since that time that WSM was just about ready to leave me go when the good Lord stepped in and guided my pen as I wrote the song.
That big eight-wheeler rolling down the track means your true-loving daddy ain't coming back, 'cause I'm moving on. I'll soon be gone. You are flying too high for my little old sky, so I'm moving on.
This song held the number one spot for 29 straight weeks and stayed on the charts for 14 months and sold 1 million copies. Hank Snow became a household word, and he continued to make country music history.
I'm an everywhere man, across the desert's bare man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I travel, I've had my share, man.
I know some place you haven't been.
I've been everywhere.
You're listening to one of the first records ever made by Floyd Kramer. It was recorded on a small label about 1950. The labels Abbott and Faber were owned by Faber Robinson, a man who made country music history. He was the first to record artists who later became big stars. For example, the first record he released was by the then unknown singer, Johnny Horton.
I'm a guy that likes his fun, and when I fight, you'd better run. I'm a mean son of a gun.
He also was the first to record The Browns.
I take the chance of causing you to doubt my love. I take the chance to be with you.
Faber Robinson was also the first to record his records as loud as possible. When one of his records was played on a jukebox, he wanted to be sure someone heard it. Faber was also the first to record the announcer of the Louisiana Hayride. Jim Reeves recalls that time.
I was asked to come to work for KWKH in Shreveport, Louisiana, the station that originated the Louisiana Hayride. Now, this is the show where a lot of stars got their start. Johnny Horton, Elvis Presley, The Browns, Webb Pierce, Kitty Wells, Johnny and Jack, Johnny Cash, and Farron Young, many other country and western artists had their beginning in Shreveport with the Louisiana Hayride. And I was asked to come there to announce for this radio station and to MC a portion of the Louisiana Hayride. And I was there as strictly an MC at first. And one night a fella didn't show up to sing his song on his segment of the show. And I had previously expressed a desire to sing on the show. The man said, well, you're a good announcer, but your singing's no good, so... And this night, when this man didn't show up to sing his song, this director of the show said, all right, you've been wanting to sing, go out and sing a song. And I grabbed a guitar and dashed out and sang a song. And a man with a recording company heard it and said, I like the song. I'd like for you to record it, which I did. And it became the number one country and western record of 1953. It was called Mexican Joe.
South of the border, hey, I know a land. He's got more fun than anybody's had. Don't got no worry, don't got no dough. Everybody's wondering about Mexican Joe. In old Mexico, they call him the Rumba King. Leads all the women around on a string. When they go out, they get a million thrills. But the lovely senoritas always wind up with the bills. Dancing, romancing, always on the go. Sun shining down on Mexican Joe.
The man who didn't show up to sing his song was Hank Williams.
Put your sweet lips a little closer to the phone. Let's pretend that we're together all alone. I'll tell the man to turn the jukebox way down low. And you can tell your friend there with you, he'll have to go.